Well, hello everybody. Today we're going to do another video on a Stryker 94 HPC, and this video is for Brandyn. Brandyn actually bought one of these for me, and he asked me if I would do a video showing how I take it out of the box and convert it and everything, and I told him I would. So we're going to get started with that. As you can see, we have a new brand new Stryker here. This is how it looks coming out of the box. Okay. We're going to go back and we have to get our microphone. It does come, as you can see, there's your accessories and bracket. It's all mounted under there. Plastic goes here, and our book goes back on top. If I can get it back in there. Alright, we need to get our microphone out. Plastic. We're going to take our radio out of the plastic. Get it out of the way. Okay, again, one of the things I want to go over with this real quick, which I know I've already done a video on, is this is a cast housing, very well built. We flip it over. We've got four screws we have to take out here, and that's how we get into the radio, and that's part of the conversion process. So, if I can grab the right screwdriver, we'll start that process. Okay, so we've removed the screws. Now you need to be really careful when you do that, by the way, because you don't want to jerk these wires out. Your speaker plugs in, right here. You see that? We'll just unplug that. That removes our speaker. So here you can see the inside of the radio again, and this is, like I said, I already did a video, so we're not going to go into a lot of detail. However, to convert this radio, we have to cut this wire right here. See that little white loop? We have to cut that. Before we go cutting on a brand new radio, though, a couple of things I like to do is just to look over the radio, see if anything looks obviously out of place, or make sure everything appears to be okay. And let's see here what we're going to do. I like to look at solder joints, coils. Now, as you notice, these coils are bent right from the factory, just a little bit on each side. Looks like we could use more light. That helps a little, maybe. It's where our finals are and driver. Filter. Okay, everything seems to be all right. Cable's in there good and tight, it looks like. All right, so what we want to do is we want to take and just cut. See if I can get this down where you can see a little better and I don't have to wobble all around. All right, so what we want to do is we want to cut this white wire, which is we're going to go in with our cutters and just simply cut the wire. Okay, the wire's been cut. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to hook the radio up, and we have to go in and change our band, and I'll show you how to do that in just a minute. Let me get the radio hooked up, and I'll be right back with you. Okay, we're back. We've got the radio hooked up. We've got our microphone attached. Now, what we've got to do this is we have to press the function and FP6 at the same time, or the P6, excuse me. So we have the function P6 pressed. We push our power button. As soon as we turn our power on, try it again. And of course, I'd already turned the radio on. Function P6, power on. There we go. All right. We're in ham frequency. We want to change that to CB frequency, HF frequency. That's 25.615 to 30 megahertz variable. Ham radio is 28 to 29.7. CB is 1 through 40. We're going to set this up to HF frequencies. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit that and enable it. Oops. Reset MCU, please wait. And we should be. Let's see, where are we? Evidently, we're not. Let's try this again. To 30 megahertz. Okay, we're there. All right, so now we want to change to get to AM. We're going to turn our volume. See, this is our volume control as we adjust it. Squelch power output, we have a shot of 10 watts or 4 watts. We'll leave it at 4 watts. Okay, so we want to go to channel 20. All right, so as you can see here, and I didn't show this before, you say 27205. And if you notice over here under D, it says C channel 20. Okay, that C20 means channel 20. So we're on our channel 20. 27205. So let's go ahead and key this thing up. We should have a 4 watt dead key, which we do. So I'm going to show you without touching. Now, I haven't touched the radio as far as anything, done any work, but I do want to show you where we're at. So let's spin this around. All right, now we're here at the watt meter, and I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. If you'll notice, we're on a 10-watt scale in our Palomar meter. You see we're on a 10-watt scale, which means we should be on this second row right below the 1,000. You see it says 1 to 10. So we're going to go ahead and key this. Okay, we're supposed to be at 4 watts, and if you'll notice, we're very close to 4 watts. We're going to go ahead and do our power and set it to 10. You notice that pegged the 10 watt scale, so it's going to be just a little bit over 10, it looks like. Yeah, just a skosh over 10. Okay. So we're really close there. Might as well go up and take a look at the frequency. Let's see if I can get this thing to go up that high. Holy moly. No, we're going to have to come back here a little bit, guys. Just bear with me on this. I'll hold it up there. If you can see here, this is our frequency counter. 27204992. Well, I'll tell you what. That's not bad. And that's right out of the box. You'll notice that we're running. Now, I will go through a couple of things here that's really nice to notice that you may have not noticed. You notice above the D, we have we're running 14.1 volts. Tells us we're in AM. That's our noise blanker circuit. Down here is all of our other information. And then, of course, we have our meters up at the top. And this is not a touch screen. So it's not like we can touch and do anything here. But each of these buttons correspond to what's listed right beside them. So if we want a RF gain control, we hit P2. RF gain's on auto. We can turn it off, or we can actually start setting the RF gain. I am going to turn it off. And then we push in our button, it's done. So that gives us an idea of what we got going on there. All right, so we know now that we're doing almost 4 watts like we should be, and we're doing just a hair over 10 watts, so we're pretty good on that. We're going to go inside now, and we're going to do a little bit of adjustment when we put a tone in it, and we're going to set our mic gain, our modulation, and we'll get that in line, and then we'll start working on the receive and see what we can do with the receive. So bear with me just a minute, and we'll have this radio flipped over, and we'll be ready to start working on our adjustments. Okay, we're back. Now, first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and set our low power and high power. And for that, we need to be in the right situation. So this should be our low power. And it is. Okay, AM, FM low power is W2. So if we go over here and look, and you'll see W2 right here. Okay, so we're going to set that. We set that right at 2 watts. Now let's go ahead with our power, and we're going to do our 10 watts. And our high power is W1. Get this thing to. And this should be our high power right here. And we want that to be 10 watts, and it is. Okay. We're slipping a little bit. Let me get this a little better centered for you. Okay. So now we've set our low power at 2 watts and our high power at 10 watts. Now let's see what we can do for audio and see how it looks. We have a 1,000 hertz tone. Our AM modulation on low power is W6. And we need to get back to low power. So we're back on low power. So we're looking at W6. As we can see, W6 is right here. So we're going to insert that. Let's get this up a little. Let's get this trace. And break that. Alright, so here's our W6. Oops, went too far. All right, so there's W6 with a tone. If you notice, that's a perfect sine wave. Now let's go ahead and do our high power. Okay, we're going to have to do some changing on this, I guarantee you. Oh, look at that. Our high power is W4. That's interesting. Look at something here. Really makes no difference. Mm-hmm. That's an interesting situation there. We've got it up. We've got good modulation, but we've got a pattern that I don't like that well. I'm going to do this again at 4 watts. Okay. Well, if you carry that too far, okay. Let's see what we've got there just a minute. Hello, test. Hello, test. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hello, test. Hello, test. Hello, test. Hello, hello, hello. Hello. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Audio. Hello, test. All right, let's go to our 10 watt. Hello, test. Hello, test. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're working, but I'd like to see something a little different. I got to do just a little more work here. Give me just a second. I'll be back. I don't want to just have you guys sitting here listening to me babble. I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. Got some things lined out there. Just had to do a little bit of more adjusting. All right, so what we've got now, we're going to set this on our 2 watts. Whoa, we're going to knock our camera over. That's what we're going to do. We're going to set this on our 2 watt scale. 4 watts, well, actually it's 4 watt scale it says, but we've got to set it to. So with our 2 watt scale, we're going to take a look at our audio. See, we've got a really nice pattern there. Everything looks good. No problem with that whatsoever. Okay. We're going to do the same thing here, and we're going to go with our 10 watt scale. So now we're set at 10 watts. Which is kind of ugly there, isn't it? There we go. So at 10 watts, with 1,000 hertz tone injected, we're seeing right at 40 watts PEP. And we've got a perfect wave. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. It's clean. It's clean. It's not going to be dirty. It's going to be giving us exactly what we want. You can't get any better than that. So at 2 watts and at 10 watts, we're achieving exactly what we want. When we talk, hello, 1, 2, 3, 4, audio test. Let me do this a little bit different. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hello, audio, 1, 2, test. We've got everything where we want it. The radio is performing good without a ton of modulation or modifications. The limiter's still intact. Our limiters are working. Our dead keys are set. The radio is performing just as it's supposed to do. We're seeing 40 watts on a tone on, let's see, audio. Tell you what, let's just bring it over here and look at the bird. That way you can see it for yourself. Let me raise this up a little bit so you can, there we go. You actually see. We'll zoom in. So we are on, as you can see, there's a 50 watt slug. We're in the center on the X1. So we need to be in the middle scale. That'll stay. The middle scale. So we're just a skosh under 10. Hello, 1, 2, 3. Hello, 1, 2, 3. Hello, 46, 47 watts PEP. Let's take a look. RMS. Hello, right at 10 watts RMS. 1, 2, 3, 4 audio test. Oh, well, we can bring her up a little if we push it. But we're looking at about 10, 11 watts RMS. And we'll go right back to our PEP. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4 audio. Audio. I mean, that's very close to 50 watts. You know, out of a radio this size, that's phenomenal. That is just phenomenal. So, no worries there. Everything's looking good. I'm pretty impressed with that. Let's take a look at the receive, and we'll see how it does. We'll see where we're at, and we'll see what kind of adjustments or modifications we have to do to that. Give me a few minutes to set up. I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. We've decided to go ahead and do a sensitivity test on the radio. We're at a negative 110 dBm, and as you can see, we're still just a hair above our 12 dB side end, and which is good. That's very good. Good sensitive receive. Shouldn't have any problem hearing anybody with that. And that's after just a small modification that I did inside. Nothing spectacular. Just basically a little bit of a tweak. Now, as you can see, let me get this volume up. Right there is exactly what we should be hearing, and that is the minimum that they say is you'll be able to hear a voice through the noise. Now, you can actually hear a little better than that, but that's what its standard is, or the industry standard is. There's no spec on this, on the signal to noise, on the SIAD, but there is a signal to noise spec, but we're well within specs. We're doing great. If we're at 12 dB at this point, we're doing great. And then at negative 110 dBm, we're doing really well. We can go, and of course, as we turn this up, as we turn up our receive, you can hear the quality, of course, come up, and we get in a really great picture. Now, I'm going to turn, I'll show you. What I want to do is give you this on the scope. And we're going to set this back at 12 dBm SIAD. Okay, now we're going to come over here and I'm going to raise you up so you can see the oscilloscope up here. Yes, I know you're wiggling all over the place, but instead of stopping the video again, I decided just to raise it up. Oh my. We're going to do a better job than that, aren't we? We'll get there. Again, I apologize for all the flopping around. I'm not a professional. Still going up, but we're going to make it. All right. Get this thing halfway set up. We want to go in number one. Probe number one. Let's see here. Display. Normal. Okay. So what we're seeing right now is we're seeing that signal, and this, what you're seeing, I want to explain to you, what you're seeing on that signal, all this jittering, jumping around and carrying on, that's noise.